با درود فراوان خانم ها آقایان دوستان گرامی به 12 برنامه بنیاد طوس با نام ترنم یادها و خاطره ها در غربت خوش آمدید.
این خانه قشنگ است ولی خانه من نیست. این خاک چه زیباست ولی خاک وطن نیست. آواره ام و خسته و سرگشته و حیران، هر جا که روم هیچ کجا خانه من نیست.
The dark clouds of revolution of 1979 banished the light of thousand years of Persian culture. The lyrical beauty of its culture, its melodies and stories vanished from the airways and TV screens. Theaters and the dance halls closed, and actors, musicians and the dancers were all forced to flee or abandon their talent.
How long have you been doing these shows?
Tell
me about Toos Foundation and how long you've been doing.
Toos Foundation is about 10 years. By the end of this year, going to be 10 years though. But I've been doing it before, and I'm coming from classical background as well. Therefore, I never left the stage.
This program takes the people very, very, very far back, and imagination, the singing, the special song. This special program doesn't need any talking. We have actually four singers in this program, and none of the song belongs to them. They are singing this song from the people who has died or still they are in Iran. They cannot be here, and people has got memory of them. Our head singer is Mario Taqaddusi, opera singer. He is singing different songs from the singers from the past.
Regardless of the religion, regardless of the color, or the, you know, beliefs or political ideas and everything, arts and music is the only thing which people has got it in them.
Is mainly, I think the Persian culture is the main things in this collection, and then you know London, so it's full of people from everywhere.
For this production, we have only 2 days. That makes it really hard. Because in 2 days we have to put the show together with the orchestra, with the dancers, with all this choreography and with the light manager and, you know, all this problem.
As the title says, it's Memories in Exile. I think it's mostly trying to allow the audience to explore the nostalgia in their head.
For the show, we have a huge orchestra rehearsal and then we go for the show. So this is very difficult.
It's obviously bringing quite a lot of different people, lots of different art forms together.
Mm-hmm.
flamenco, yeah, Spanish dance, which I really like. It's something spicy. It's got spicy in it.
ترنم یادها و خاطره ها در غربت. Just remembering the past. We had the memory from the past. That's why the program is without talking.
Music and dance go past cultures, and we can relate to them and feel something. And if somebody else feels something from what I'm doing, the communication I have with Mario the singer, or generally all the music and the beautiful dance that's going on, the classical, the contemporary, the folk music, from all different areas, to me, I don't think, oh, this is Iranian, that's Western, that's, it's just good music and beautiful dance, and I think I'm so excited to be part of it, and I feel really honoured to be part of something so multicultural and beautifully produced, so I'm happy.
So is this quite a novel experience then? Have you ever done anything for a Persian cultural evening before?
Not me, the first time.
Your first time? And you?
I think so. Not that I recall that I've done another Persian cultural. I think I would remember, yeah. So no.
It's my first time as well.
If I wasn't doing anything active on the stage, I was promoting the others, because I believe whoever comes out is new to me. That's it.
And you finance the whole entire production?
From the
sandwiches at break time to the dancers on the stage.
Absolutely. Costumes, choreography, dancers, yes, security, everything. Everything I do it myself. And we wanted to promote the Iranian culture and the effect of the cross cultures on Iranian heritage, basically.
در این بهار چو رویا در عطر خواب پریا گل میبارد از شاهه ها بر روی دختر زیبا.
When I dance, there's like, it's like an alter ego comes out. For me, I can be so flirtatious when I'm dancing and make Mario feel, the singer feel, that I'm playing with him and I may want to be with him and I may not. He takes the manton from me, so there's a lot of playfulness in it. And for as an artist, as flamenco artist also, it's really challenging to be able to choreograph this piece to something that isn't flamenco. And normally flamenco, we're real purists, like flamenco puro.
It's got flamenco music, it's got classical, it's got folk, it's got even traditional Iranian music. But sometimes, you know, you get involved with the daily life and you forget about stuff that, you know, you've left back in Iran.
We always give our humanitarian messages through the arts, through the dance, through the choreography, through the songs. We still remember the familiar perfume of hello. We still remember that violets are the signs of the spring. And we still remember, as long as there are poppies, life is worth living.
Atmosphere actually is singing, dancing, and music. There is nothing else.
I think she just has a taste for grand things, you know, a production this big. Her attention to details is extraordinary, you know, that she remembers the tiniest thing, you know, the coordination, arrangements, this sort of production, and in Iranian, which doesn't happen very often.
Curious to see how tomorrow goes, everything, and we hope good.
Yeah, what happened? Yeah, tell me a little bit about what happened.
Mr. Karadus, he just arrived from hospital. Because he fell from the stage and he broke his hand. Thanks God that I was at the beginning. I was worried for the last ball when we introduced the artist and everything, and so we called everybody on stage. His back was towards the audience, right on the edge. So all of a sudden he said, yes! One step out and he fell off. And he landed over his hand.
So you're
going to
sing on painkillers?
On painkillers. Even the painkillers doesn't work. And it was like in two different places broken. And they pulled it out and in.
But you're a true artist because you're continuing. Enjoy the show. It's going to be one of a kind.
I try to get my.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 4 o'clock here at the final rehearsal, before Mr. Takatosi came to do the sound check, unfortunately he fell off the stage. He was taken to hospital with the ambulance from here, and just about the first song that he sang for you, he arrived here. But love of you, love of the stage and the sense of responsibility put him again here.
ممنونم خانم جمیل خروازی. I'm going to give my best. Thank you.
دم کل دم کل دم کل دم کل چاوسیا دم کل دم کل دم کل دم کل چاوسیا.
The show must go on, even if I've got my hand broken, if I have a lot of pain, but I have to sing. I sing for all my public in London and all these beautiful Persian people.
Difficult and turbulent days in which our country is being promised bit by bit to foreigner powers, and the world hardly remembers how we came to be separated from our roots and how we have influenced each other in arts, music, dance, technology, and science. We try in exile to teach our youth with their brighter minds, their roots, beliefs, and their historical facts of our country.
The light is very bad because of that. You see many words.
Okay, Edmund.
Hello.
The light will be different this evening.
History, you know, everything to show new generation what we had in Iran and who we are actually, and this is important.
The story of a performance is set at an auction house in 19th century London.
In today's auction, we will sell items which remind us of the golden days in the works of those remarkable artists who are no longer with us. We remember them with the deepest respect. Item number one, the last costume that a woman, freedom fighter, war before her execution. 30 guineas. 35 guineas. 50 guineas. Once, twice, sold 50 guineas.
Thank you.
since long past days, poetry has been the language of the inner soul. But fear, fear of speaking frankly of unspeakable facts, has created the language of symbols and imagination. That is how we are interpret every poem, every time we face it again.
It's terribly, terribly emotional. I mean, I don't remember pre-revolutionary Iran, but all this is about nostalgia and pre-revolutionary Iran. And I suppose for those who remember, that the happiest songs are actually the saddest for them, because it reminds them of the good times, and which are no more, except here. And thank God for the Tooth Foundation that keeps these things alive.
Thank you.
the artist, the art, there is something which, when somebody involved in this sort of things, never can forget it. And always when doing this sort of job, they are happy, they are want to do the best they can. That's why they are so excited.
You're seated, aren't you?
You're preset. Right, so you're preset.
As I do the gramophone, move the gramophone, that's like the music starts. So that's the cue.
Thank you.
popular songs and dances from different lands of Persia suddenly disappeared from everyday life. Record players and the transistors, now deemed immoral, went silent. Only the melodies lingered and the passion still burned.
Up. I think the musicians nowadays in this country especially are exceptionally good at sight reading, so just being a bit of music in front of them and they understand not only just the notes but the style of the music and how to make it, you know, give it authenticity. So to do something like the concertina with the santur, which is tuned to a different scale, you know, one of the notes, the A flat, needs to be significantly sharper. So for especially violinists who are trained to put their finger down in a specific place for an A flat, and every time an A flat came, they had to just make it a little bit sharper, going against years of training. Yeah, that was one of the challenges, but they rise to it and they seem to enjoy it. But they're no amazing musicians. They pick things up so quickly and a joy to work with. I think especially when you then see the dancers and hear the singers, and especially with emergencies in the afternoon with one of the singers breaking his wrist on the afternoon of the concert, we then have sudden sort of, you know, this is going to be an electric show, spontaneity comes out.
The santur, oh, that was incredible. And the difference to the way the orchestra had to re-pitch our A-flats to get it together.
و این بنیاد توس یکی از اهداف اصلیش اینه که معرفی کنه، بشناسونه و جوانان، مخصوصا جوانانی که خارج از ایران هستن، آشنا بشن با فرهنگ و مخصوصا هنر ایرانی.
Amore, no più pensato a te. Aperto gli occhi per guardare intorno a me. Intorno a me giravi il mondo come sempre. Gira, il mondo gira nello spazio senza fine. Con gli amori appena nati, con gli amori già finiti, con la gioia e col dolore della gente come me. Il mondo مهتاب شبی باز از آن کوچه گذشتم، همه تن چشم شدم خیره به دنبال تو گشتم، شوق دیدار تو لبریز شد از جام وجودم، اشکی از شاخ فرو ریخت باغ صد خاطر خندی، عطر صد خاطر پیچید اشکی از چشم تو لغزی، نگسستم نرمیدم حذر از عشق ندانم، من به تماشای نگاه تو، همه راز جهان چشم سیاه تو، تو دلت با دگران نه،
gördüm bağda yatı ceyran mene bağ bağ moral mene bağ bağ kara teller güle batı ceyran mene bağ bağ güzel mene bağ bağ kumar oldum kumar oldum kumar
people see orchestras or classical singers, opera singers, as maybe elitist or snobbish, or, and it just isn't. You know, you could hear the audience reacting, clapping and cheering. And so for the popular songs, I even heard somebody singing along early on, one of the songs that they really recognised.
Underground, in private, and on distant shore, this culture survived through its community, intent to keeping alive its heritage to remind both themselves and the rest of the world how beautiful and cultured Persia was, and to share those memories through the arts with succeeding generations.
like the traditional music, Iranian especially. I mean, I really enjoyed the traditional Persian song.
It was a mix of actually Iranian traditional music and opera and classical music. It was a very nice mixture.
Yeah, I'm enjoying it, to be honest, because it's a different culture. You're starting to learn other songs, other languages, and it's, I like it.
The other thing is, which has worked to our advantage today, but it's not going to happen tomorrow, is that we get to see the orchestra as well as the conductor. But in tomorrow, the way the stage is set, the orchestra is going to be behind us. We're literally going to be back to back with the conductor, which is the worst possible layout.
Thank you.
We see no one is in the world. It's like Tooth Foundation without expecting anything to come in to do something like this. This is a very big show with a lot of cost. And you know, with the cost, with the just a ticket, selling ticket, you can never cover this big show. So it's Tooth Foundation that does this, and we are appreciating Jamil Kharrazi that she does this, and we are all supporting her for this.
Since time immemorial, woman has been much part of Persian culture as the morning star or the crescent moon, as goddess, queen, heroine, lover, bride, mother, daughter, sister, slave or concubine. She has seen her world and her position constantly changed. Her stories should not be forgotten or banned just because she is a woman.
زنجیریان هستند مردانی که مردار زنان را دوست می‌دارند. در این زنجیریان هستند مردانی که در رؤیایشان هر شب زنی در وحشت مرگ از جگر برمی‌کشد فریاد. جرمین است. جرمین است.
In Tooth, we try to fill the gap between our yesterday and today by music and songs. Tonight's program is a colorful musical reminder of our memories. We welcome the coming of the spring and the celebration of the light of life. Such poetry can begin with the print of a red flower on a shirt or on a spot on a colored hijab. In Tooth, we express ourselves with poetry covered with musical sheer and movements emerging from thoughts.
Thank you. برنامه فوق العاده جالبه، فوق العاده قشنگه. واقعا باید قدر زحمات خانم جمیله خلیجی رو دونست و زنده کردن هنر ایرانی، موسیقی ایرانی، آداب و رسوم ایرانی، آهنگ‌های فولکلوریک ایرانی. و من در همه برنامه‌ها بودم و خوشحالم. خداوند به ایشون سلامتی و موفقیت برای همیشه بده.
Because of the tragedy that happens in France, and of course we are going to offer our condolences to people. But all of a sudden yesterday, that we had all day rehearsal, we understood that the rumor has been spread that Tous has been cancelled the show because of that. So because of that, we had to contact the Scotland Yard, and we got the extra security upstairs. I don't know whether you've noticed or not, when you came there, all the bags and everything would be checked.
It, with very serious things going on around the world, it can be something that makes you proud to be a human being, almost, restores your faith. That people who may not necessarily speak much of the same language in talking can communicate with, obviously, the cliched universal language, but it's true.
I can imagine it now. I can see it, you know, on this stage, you know, with the bow tie, you know, the whole thing. I mean, rehearsals like this, yeah, you turn up in your jeans and, you know, the dancers, you know, just, you know, trying to be as comfortable as they can be. But, you know, when you're in the green room behind the stage, you know, everybody's dressing up, you know it's gonna be good. And I think it deserves to be one of the good performances I've seen in a while, because God knows how many hours has gone into to the preparation of this, you know, to the tiniest detail. I mean, I've seen people running with rose petals, you know, you forgot your rose petals, you know, you're gonna use it in this song. It's that much detail, you know, that much attention to the detail.
I think it's exemplary. Any initiative that brings people together as a community cohesion initiative, I think is excellent.
با سرگردان هایی که در کوچه ها هندار می فروشند چگونه زندگی کنیم، چون ما هنوز عطر آشنای سلام را یاد داریم. هنوز یادمان هست که بنفشه نشان ورود بهار به خانه است. هنوز باور داریم که تا شقایق هست زندگی.